What if I tell you there's a large language model on this USB? You plug it into your computer and all of a sudden you have access to LLM even when you're offline. Furthermore, it can generate files automatically in your storage. All you have to do is name the file and the content will be written for you. This is what I made, and today I'm going to show you how. When I had this idea, I resolved to use something I already have lying around, which I shouldn't have in retrospect. An 8-year-old Pi Zero wireless. This thing is quite a dinosaur by now. It packs 512 megabytes of RAM and a single core with ARM v6 architecture. It's perfect, it's quite small and can easily pass as a beefy USB. The only thing it doesn't have is an USB mail port, which we can easily mod on. Look at these little pads on the bottom. After a little research on the internet, I found these 4 pins to be D+, D-, 5V, and ground. Using this knowledge, we can just solder some wire to mod an USB mail onto the Raspberry Pi Zero, but if you know why there's a D+, and D- on a USB interface, then soldering random wire is not a thing you should do. Although it honestly doesn't matter over short distance anyway. Since I want to not make this a hack, but a good looking device that can serve more tricks in the future, I just bought a shield online. Then being as extra that I am, I went into Fusion 360 and designed a weird looking case for all of this. I just bought this 3D printer, a secondhand S1 Pro for $100. I modded it to run Clipper, so there was a lot of parameters I didn't know about. So the designing the case took several revisions, but at the end, I got this. As anyone who's been trying to run local LLM for some time, my first choice when coming into this project was Llama.cpp. But running it on a 512 megabytes of RAM Pi Zero is not as trivial as you think due to architecture-specific optimizations. I built it from source just as the instruction told, but lo and behold, errors after errors. And better, no one has ever documented the same error I had or a working Llama.cpp build on Pi Zero or Pi 1. So I had to take matters into my own hands. First, we have to understand what we're working with. The Pi Zero has an ARM 1176 JZF CPU, which we can validate using LSCPU. Searching online prompts us to more stories about this IP line from ARM, like it was released 23 years ago and it's running on ARM v6 instruction set architecture, compared to the more recent v8a on Pi 5. The higher the version, the more cool instructions are introduced to aid things like AI inference. GGML, the framework Llama.cpp used, requires these 3 instructions, which is accessible through ARM Neon framework. Lacking these instructions made the program uncompilable due to hard-coded architecture-specific optimization for ARM in Llama.cpp. This is me talking in retrospect, of course, because finding this issue was not trivial at all.
Man, this is craziness.
No one mentioned this error online. The CMYK file built successfully, even after it checks if the system has the mentioned ARM instructions. I tried a ton of compiler flags to no avail. The build files just ignore everything and compile with non-compatible flags to an inevitable failure. Furthermore, compiling all of this on a 23 years old CPU takes more than 12 hours.
It's currently near 4 a.m. and this has been building since like 11 p.m. yesterday. And it's only at 78%, so this literally is compiling on the Pi Zero and it's been compiling for 5 hours. Shit.
So if you have any errors, if you're lucky, you'll see it within the first hour of your compilation. I cost more than a week to debug this, and even resolved to using Llama 2C by Andras Karpathy, but doing so would be so easy, I didn't settle on that. I have to pinpoint the exact optimization code and delete it by hand. But Here's the end result.
We have successfully built Llama.cpp on a freaking Pi Zero W, guys. I'm SSHing into this Pi Zero, and as you can see, I've already LS. There are three models. The first one is a 77 million parameters Llama.mini. Second is small, 135 billion. And the last one is Tiny Stories, which if you use Llama.2c by Andras Karpathy, then you already know. All these models are 4-bit quantized. And now I'm going to run it. So Llama CLI, we input the model, and let's try from the smallest to the biggest. The smallest is a tiny 15 million parameters. And let's do, say, it's the story model. So there is a toy in the corner. And we are going to limit the output to 64 tokens. And also, we will, this is okay. And it's running. As you can see, it's pretty fast because this is only a 50 million parameter model. And as I've tested this before, the token generation is about 300 milliseconds. Oh yes, it's 200 millisecond per token. And now if we were to change it to a larger model, per se, the Llama.mini, then yes, unable to load model. Here again. Nice. So as you can see, it releases an Endnote text token. Also, we put 64 token, but it releases an Endnote text, so it ends early. So the seconds per token is 2.5 milliseconds.
Now comes the fun part. How are we going to communicate with our USB? If you think just a chat interface through serial or Ethernet, then it's too basic. My goal is to make a plug and play device, which is usable without any installed app or custom driver. We have to devise a new way to interact with LLM like never before. So this is what I thought. Imagine if you want to write a horror story. All you have to do is plug this USB in, open the file, create a new file, and name it a horror story. And bam, a few moments later, inside is an auto-generated horror story for you. Now this is a bit tricky. If you know, Linux supports UAB gadgets, which essentially turns an USB host into an USB device with custom functionalities. This means you can turn your computer into an HID device or a MIDI device at your will. In our case, we turn it into a composite device, which support Ethernet, serial, and mass storage at the same time. Now making the device act like an USB is trivial. It's just a matter of enabling the right kernel model, creating a file system file, and configure the USB module. However, making the Pi Zero detect file changes is not so trivial. If files were to be changed on the Pi side, such change would not reflect on the computer side, unless we mount and dismount the system.
You can see right here that the drive just shows up. And if we were to go into here, live TXT, we will see life was an amazing life.
If changes were to be made on the Pi side though, if we unmount it manually, the Pi is simply shut down. So we need to somehow signal the Pi to disable and enable the USB kernel model to kind of soft mount it. This is done with a simple bash script that constantly pulls for changes with the file system binary file.
Okay, so you can see that I've already run the command continue.sh on 0pi, which basically does all the scanning and updating of the created files with LLM. I'll put that in the description. Now, per se, for example, if we open the USB folder and we create a terminal inside of there, and let's say if we touch a file called bing.txt and
that will create an empty file. And yes, of course, you can see in here that is detected by the LLM on the Pi Zero. And you can see it automatically unmount and mount the USB, which is incredible. And of course, you can also see here that the file is still empty. This is due to syncing problems of the USB. Normally, I have to unplug and replug this USB. Okay, so you can see the device is still connected. I just reset it. I promise I didn't do anything manually. And I just checked the error message on the SSH of Pi. But this is the moment of truth. If we go in right now and we see a new file input, yes! And you can see that. And exactly, if we were to run the continue.sh on here, I'll demonstrate again that if we were to run it and we were to open another folder in terminal, I'll put this here so that you can see it clearer. Yes. And you see that if I were to touch to create a file on here, for example, life.txt, then you see that the zero Pi can accurately detect that and generate a prompt for me. And you also see the file explorer refreshing because the USB is unmounted. I'm going to do this, create a file, life. And yeah, yes, the text is being generated by an LLM on the USB. And you can see it's being refreshed right there and loaded back again.
And thanks to that, we have the first plug and play LLM USB in the world. Just plug this into any device, name a file the way you want it, and it would fill the content based on the name. And at its current caliber, it doesn't amount to anything useful, of course, but it serves as a good example for future personal local LLM. With models like commuter use, we can even make a USB that can control any computer automatically. If there's any question, don't hesitate to ask in the comments section. Materials are mentioned in the description. And finally, subscribe and like this video if you'd love to see more content like this in the future.